It's that time of year again where the bells are ringing and the sleds are sleighing. In honor of the festive seasons, I've put together my top 5 Christmas special. So let's begin. At number 5 we have It's a SpongeBob Christmas. Now this SpongeBob Christmas special doesn't follow the typical animation style we've come to expect from SpongeBob, as this was made in stop motion animation. So this gives us visuals very different from the usual SpongeBob. But the story goes as follows. SpongeBob accidentally infects the whole town and gives them a bad case of jerkitis due to the fruitcake that he made everybody eat, which has been laced by jerktonium, but he does not notice. So what happens is that everybody becomes a jerk and everybody starts to act extra cranky. And this is very, very bad because SpongeBob is worried that Santa won't come and visit the town. So SpongeBob and Sandy find out that the antidote to all of this is his song. SpongeBob then proceeds to sing Don't Be a Jerk to everybody, and they return back to normal. But they do this too late, and it is found out by Santa that everybody was evil. So Santa says everybody's naughty, but everything is cleared up before Plankton gets his hands on the formula. Now the reason I love this special is just because everything feels so natural. It's not like the SpongeBob that's going on currently, where it's like the writers force SpongeBob to act way dumber and way unnatural than it already is. The show also features a song, Don't Be a Jerk, which is actually one of my favorite. So that's why this gets my pick to be in this list. At number 4, we have the Charlie Brown Christmas special. And now if you are very unfortunate to not know who this man is, then you must have had one of the worst childhoods ever. I'm joking. No, I'm serious. You have missed a lot of awesome content if you do not know who Charlie Brown is. Even though it's only 30 minutes long, the show packs a punch in the message it portrays. It follows the story of Charlie Brown, probably the unluckiest kid in the world, as he struggles to find any form of enthusiasm during the Christmas season. He finally gets the real meaning of Christmas from his friends, and once they decorate his puny Christmas tree, he returns in a better mood and they end it off. A simple ending for a simple yet effective special. As I said before, this special is very old, 55 years to be exact. And since animation wasn't all that mainstream back then, companies couldn't be spending millions of dollars on production value and visuals. So this means that even though this show doesn't really pack that animation punch, it makes up for that in wonderful storytelling. And that didn't stop this show from turning into one of the best Christmas specials of all time. And I just want all of you to go and watch it just because of how good it is. And if you have time, check out the other Charlie Brown specials because they're all top-notch quality. From the outside looking in and from the surface, they might not look like they are just because of their animation style, but they are awesome, and you just gotta check all of them. Number 3, we have Regular Show. And at first, I didn't really expect Regular Show to come out with a Christmas special, but once they did, I knew it was goldie. In this Christmas special, everything we've known to love about Regular Show appears. The bromance between Mordecai and Rigby and them working together to disprove something. In this special, when they try to get everybody to help them help Santa, everybody thinks they're lying at first. But then after proving it to them, they can go out and recruit other people to help them. We even have Gene in the rival park make an appearance in this as he helps the gang. This is just so awesome just because also the mini games that the cast go through, especially Benson with that pinball game. And just awesome overall. The special also features Carol of Bells at the ending scene, which is actually the first time I heard that song and actually introduced myself to Pentatonix, which is one up of the show. So let's give it up for Regular Show because they introduced me to Pentatonix. But yeah, an overall great special, and I think it is deserving of this spot in the list. Now let's move on to number 2. Adventure Time Christmas special, and holy cow, flip a what? This special is just mind-boggling, mind-blowing, like what? It gives us more insight into the life of the Ice King. It shows us that he is not who he seems, and that this guy that we thought was a one-dimensional kooky villain, is actually someone much more. He was actually a scientist that just got a cursed crown. And we actually find out so much more about Ice King that whenever you look at him in other episodes, you actually pity him. You actually get to pity him and you actually feel bad for him because it's not his fault that he's like this. And just look at it. Just take a look and look at the guy who's on the screen right now. If you compare him to this guy, it's just wow. Like, who knew? And the way they did this special was so amazing. You know, most animated shows make their specials one-off, but nah, this special is one of the most important episodes in the whole series. And I'm just glad that this was the way that they structured it. Another awesome special for an awesome YouTuber. Let's go to number one and my favorite Christmas special of all time. That is the Family Guy Christmas special. Now, even Family Guy have made a lot of Christmas specials, but this is definitely my favorite one. To begin with, the song that's in the beginning that everybody tells what they want for Christmas is just awesome. And the episode is actually genuinely funny. You know, right now the modern day Family Guy isn't so good, and there are so many times where I have just watched an episode and I've been like, come on, or that's a miss. But nah, this special is actually funny. There's so many times where I just find myself cracking up to the many jokes that were in this. And the show is also fantastic as it gets Brian and Stewie together to go on this big trip. You know, the time when Stewie wanted to kill everybody and that's the only thing he had in his head. That's just awesome. They went back to their roots, and that's something that made me really, really happy. Because Family Guy at its roots was one of the best animated TV shows on air. And if you disagree with that, come and fight me. I will fight you for this. But it was, and I think this episode just shows you the great relationship Stewie has with Brian and how well they can work together when they really want to. That's why I love this. And if you did enjoy this video, please leave a thumbs up and subscribe. Other Christmas specials include the American Dad Christmas special. I can't really think of anything, so just remember to have a Merry Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, just in case this is the last episode I post. So I'll see you guys next time, and enjoy. Boop!